with me here.
My whole clean outfit. I'm gonna get it all gross. Pancake, I don't know if that was meant for my jet. Otherwise, I'm very confused.
But still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. I just need to find the right tool for each
some
role.
Fucking thinger. Fucking magic. Fuel filter, serpentine belt, battery post. Alright, at least she knows many of them. What we got? Oh, we got another page. I think I want a tattoo. Yeah, I know, it's permanent, right? But that's the thing, though. It's not. Not really, because we're not permanent at all. Funny how much simpler life seems when you keep that in mind. Like my hair. I wanted to see what it would look like blue, so I did it. It looks awesome. One day I'll make it all blue. If I don't like it then, so what? It'll all fall eventually. See how that works? You know what else isn't permanent? David. He actually tried to be nice to me. In the most awkward way imaginable. Then he tried to connect with me about his dead friend, which, fine, A for effort, I guess. Eventually, I got out of there and headed for the garage, which Sable is transforming into his own personal asshole cave. At least I got what I came for, Dad's toolbox. I bet he would have liked the idea of me using his tools to fix a ride. Off to the junkyard to see if I can get that truck working. I know it's far from permanent, but here's hoping the beast has a little more life in it. Chloe, the impermanent marker. Alright, Pancake, am I missing a message from you or something? Okay, so you're in Motorcycle, right? The water smells like sulfur, and now you have an odor from the water. Gross! You smell like sulfur? You smell like volcano farts? That's gnarly. David, dang. Chloe, this is David. Did my mom give you my number? Yes, she did. I know she took your father's toolbox. Are you working on a project? Sort of. What kind of project? Sorry, I'm a little busy right now. Well, I'm glad to see you're taking an interest in something. Keep it up. Alright. Check the battery post.
This connection is pretty shaky.
Tighten it up.
I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it.
Wrench it up.
Not helping.
Wait, how? Maybe
this
your cap shouldn't do anything.
Pretty gunked up.
Yep, it needs cleaned. But that's
I
not gonna fix
I
anything.
Move on to something else.
Yep. Let me check the fuck-a-ma-jig.
The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap.
Can I actually reach into the toolbox? Oh! Okay, it's switching my tool. Okay. Wrench, give me that. Okay. I get it. Pliers. Give me those. You smell like volcano farts and cigarettes. Does my family smoke in the house? Ew.
I can definitely see some problems.
That's gross. Cigarettes definitely smells. Ugh.
Like
I hate the smell of cigarette smoke.
Glove.
Okay. What is this?
Pretty loose. How can I tighten it? Not helping.
Let's check the fuel filter.
This thing is gunked the fuck up.
Oh, let's turn on the radio. Needs a music while we work.
Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up. Sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient...
Skip Matthews, hey!
...better than anything I can do.
Say hi to the fans, Skip.
Better leave it be.
Hi, fans!
Now, Skip,
what's up, dude?
I understand you work as a security guard at Blackwell Academy. Is that true?
I used to. I quit, actually.
Really? Well, hold on to your horses, folks.
This might actually clean it off.
His head has traded in his badge and six-shooter for a life of rocking faces.
Hell yeah.
Fantastic.
I love how goofy he sounds.
And if you haven't heard these guys yet, what I want you to do is crank that stereo up as loud as it goes.
That should help keep shit distributed.
His head rules?
Nailed it.
Well, fuck.
Alright, got it. Oh, now I gotta reattach it.
Go back from whence you came.
I love her interactions. Blowing it.
Maybe.
Ugh. Take out the wrench. Let's fix this. Fix the belt. There you go. Nice. Nailed it.
Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course.
Hey, our little dream that we had, Dad said the spark plug was, brand new. Foreshadowing. Although, that was from a dream, so I guess that doesn't really count as foreshadowing.
Please? I need you.
Heck yeah! We did a thing. Emergency brake.
Yeah.
Nice. We got some wheels. And a sick blue light. Dude, bobblehead. Bop the bobblehead for good luck. Don't hit Rachel. Check the fuel gauge, too. Nice! A little celebratory drive around the junkyard. I don't want to change out of these clothes. I like these new clothes.
Junkyard Queen, where are you at? Hey. Holy shit. Your hair. It's so...
badass.
Badass?
Hell fucking yeah, man! Oh, her and I are the same person.
But, yeah. Badass, too. Hey. Not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Hey, Price.
Sup, dude? Wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his.
Just Ross just grinned. Clean flower scent again. He's like, see all this new skin?
Aren't you?
New. What's Rule 63?
Hey, I thought we were cool after that Drew North thing. Don't you want to be cool?
Dots.
Gotta say, I really dig the whole tough girl thing. Frank was right about you. How'd you like to work full-time for us?
Don't fucking touch her.
Everyone has an opposite sex version of them? Nice. Pretty sure Chloe is far cooler and more attractive than I am. But she and I definitely think a lot alike.
Chicks think it's
but she actually acts it out. I don't.
But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing.
You grabbed Chloe first, dickwad.
You were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yep.
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't. Huh. Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you. But he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know right now why you give a shit about this woman.
Why do you care so much?
Why do you care so much?
Because fuck you. I'm asking the questions here.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No.
She's my mom.
Tell me where she is. Now, Rachel.
Chloe's like, shit.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your
Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Shit.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know.
We know.
We're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither. But I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter.
Are you gonna do something to her? You're an idiot.
Right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
Shit. Shit. Shit.
You fucking bitch.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, I thought he was gonna stab her. He did.
Rachel. What the fuck? Chloe, go now.
Fuck, man. We gotta get to the hospital. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Whoa, stay awake. Yo, Rachel. You gotta shake her, man. Fuck. Wrap something. Shirt off. Tighten it around the wound. Yo! Ah! This is why you take first aid. Oh, please, truck, don't break down on us. Oh, man. Holy crap, dude. Another loading screen. Oh, man. I thought he stabbed us in the stomach, and then it was like, no. Nah. And then all of a sudden, right in the arm. Got crazy, dude. All she had to say is, she's my mom, apparently, in my real life. What the hell? I know maybe you shouldn't negotiate with drug dealer gangsters in the underworld, but... Excuse me. You think there'd be some leverage on his part? He's like, oh shit, that's her real mom? Alright, maybe I'll get some more information here. Yo! We got an emergency! Holy shit, dude. Is that my fault because I said I'd meet up with Frank to find out stuff? Shit. Would this have happened if I didn't say that? Don't you fucking blame me. Walks weird. Stand Rachel up. What do you know?
Is going to be right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's out of surgery. And now she's
my heart.
Chloe, what happened?
It's my fault.
It's my fault. I should have listened to you. Sarah's mixed up somehow with this psycho Damon Merrick.
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I need the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
To ask about Sarah.
He asked us why we were so interested in Sarah.
And what did you say?
Nothing, of course.
Is that how it became violent?
He wanted dirt on you, or Rachel got angry? Because both happened. He wanted dirt on you.
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
It was my fault. Nah, I should have said the other one.
I called her Rachel. And he figured it out from there.
It's not your fault. What happened next?
Damon had a knife out. We all could see it. But